Dad, Dad, what's a penguin's favourite relation? Antarctica, son. So you want a letter from the sergeant's desk, eh? Well, you're welcome to it.
Good evening, everybody. It's a Friday evening. What am I doing sat in front of the camera on a Friday evening? It's the most excitement I get all week. Anyway, it's the 5th of June. June is well underway. So we've now got the warmest... No, it's not the warmest part of the year. It's been decidedly chilly. Anyway, we've got a few things to impart to you tonight, so we shall take them one at a time. We have the result of yesterday's theme tune quiz, and I have to say that one of the pieces did puzzle me, and we're just... It's gone down to Sky Sports football coverage. But apparently the NFL have used it. Anyway, it's not important. So we've got to do that. Okay, tell me how you get on after. Do you remember the old tricks of going up to the announcement desk at airports and giving them a piece of paper? Can you announce this person? Can you get them to come to the desk? And it, when they did, it looked quite all right written down. But when you say it, it's a bit rude. Well, the same thing's happened to a local radio station, I'm afraid. So I've just got this way. Enjoy.
Okay, let's get to our first, straight away to our first dedication. Dear Chris, please say a big hello to Connie Lingus, who's 69 on Tuesday. She'll be enjoying my meat and two veg on Sunday at 12, which are all the very best, and tell her I look forward to seeing her when she comes. Thanks ever so much, says Ivan R. Don. And he says, please say hello to Bill as well. And that comes from Ivan going out to Connie in Thurnby Lodge here in Leicestershire.
I don't know how they didn't spot that coming. Theme of the day is penguins. Dad, who's a favourite penguin relation? Oh, it's the Antarctica. Oh, very witty. First produced in Scotland in 1938 and eventually bought by the company who now run Vitties. And they're made predominantly at their factory in Levensume, just over the Stockport boundary. And they've been into a couple of disputes with other companies. Asda tried to make one that was very, very similar. And they got into a bit of a lawsuit with them. And they have a joke on them. Not a joke, a conundrum. Like, you know, who's their favourite relation, that sort of thing. How do they get round? How do penguins get about on a bicycle? Oh, yeah, very fun. But what I have to say is, do you know how to do a penguin straw? I will demonstrate. I have the article here, which I will now open. Now, I should point out, I've had this one in the fridge because it makes it easier to do. What one does is you bite a corner off, okay? Then you bite the opposite corner, okay? Then you get your cup of tea and you dip one corner into the tea and suck it through. And you get the it's one of those moments. You get a combination of the tea and the penguin. But you have to be quick, otherwise the penguin dissolves. Penguin straw. I challenge you to do. I've got a crime-fighting tale. In the mid to late 90s, I took a squad of lads to an address on Greenwood Road in Bench Hill. A lovely part there. It won't surprise you that the particular flats that we went to this day, they've all gone. We've been levelled. And basically, there were four flats, two on each floor, one in underneath, one, two, three, with a staircase up the middle. And where we were going up the stairs to the first flat upstairs on the left. It was a drugs bust. And we weren't surprised when we got there to find a metal grill over the front door. We'll give that a snip, that. And then we got the wham ram, and we started hitting the door. And we hit the door. And we hit the door again. This door was solid. And it's sometimes that the point of weakness is actually the frame. And I think that's what went this time. And eventually the whole door went down inside. What we weren't to know was that the people who occupied the flat had a fish tank. Now, the distance from the door to the fish tank, you couldn't have calculated it better. It just swung down and just clipped the bottom corner of the fish tank. So, but by the time we got our senses together and got through the door, there's a fountain of water coming out of this bloody fish tank. The whole of the floor was absolutely awash. Oh God, you got started to get fish flapping around in the fish tank. Meanwhile, we've got a load of people in the flat we're trying to keep a grip of, and they've got drugs in there. Oh, the next minute, the woman's up from downstairs screaming Blue Mary. You bloody lot, what are you doing? There's water coming through my flat. Meanwhile, I got another officer with a pan out of the kitchen. Getting the fish in the pan. She said, oh, by the way, sir, do you want to go in the kitchen and see what's on the chopping board? And my first glance was, I thought it was a block of serene. No, it was a block of cannabis. A good size. A good size block of cannabis with a carving knife next to it, for God's sake. As if, you know, they're waiting for the next person to... I'd have had to see a slice with your tea. Oh, some stolen goods and some drugs. But the worst thing was having to deal with this bloody fish tank. Oh, God. Why does everything just go tits up when you're trying to just do a straightforward job? Yeah. Yeah. Just another inch back. If this fish tank had been an inch further back, door would have missed it completely. Nah. No chance. Yeah. The fish tank of Greenwood Road. I remember it well. An Italian transport photograph from the mid-60s. It was a forecast of what transport in the 2025 was going to be like. And you know, they might not be wrong. Driving around in individual bubbles. Trust the Italians. I love it when old people reminisce. Photographs being sent to me. Ah, that nice, isn't it? Hey, the good old days. I like this photograph. I'll do the voiceover for it.
I didn't see you at camouflage training this morning, Murphy. Well, thank you, sir.
My liaison officer, Joe, sent me this picture. I'd heard about this story from McDonald's, but I didn't believe it until I saw the picture. And basically, McDonald's aren't opening except for drive-throughs. So what do you do if you haven't got a car? This is what you do. And he got served. Good for him. Good for him. I love it. I suppose if you haven't been to the pub for a bit, it's only right that given the opportunity, you should sink some beer barrels.
When will I see you?
A lovely song. Summer of 1974. I remember it well. I'll tell you why. Because it was the US elections and Nixon was in the process of getting himself in a right pickle. And also, I was working in a frozen pea factory. There you go. And shoveling peas off the floor back onto the conveyor belt so they could get frozen and sent to Italy. I didn't eat frozen peas for a year after that. Pound an hour they paid us. Pound an hour. 12 hours on, 12 hours off, pound an hour. This gentleman has been waiting up every day to find out whether the restrictions are going to allow him to go to the pub or a restaurant, or the cinema, or I don't think he was expecting the in-laws round.
Men's 100 metres. Usain Bolt will run in the seventh lane. He's the first Jamaican to win gold in the 100 metres. Previous winners: Jesse Owens, Harrison Dillard, Bob Hayes, Carl Lewis, Maurice Green, and Justin Gatlin himself, who appears once again here. He was the 2004 champion.
And here comes Usain Bolt! Usain Bolt storming through! He takes it again! Blake gets the silver! 9.64!
Just before I go, I got somebody who wants to... Hey, what are you doing? Yes, I know, but it's my podcast, not yours. What's that? You want to go and beat Sweep up because he's been naughty? I don't know. But you've only just arrived. I know. Izzy Wizzy, let's get busy, shall we? Yeah. You're going to wave bye-bye to everybody? All right, okay. Say bye-bye. And what's that? Are you going to introduce your new friend? Yes, I know. Annabelle is here as well. And we'll introduce her on Monday, okay? So. He's got a new friend called Annabelle, and she's just arrived as well. And what? Oh no, you can't do that to Charlie. He doesn't deserve that. Okay, all right. Bye bye everybody. All right. Sorry about that. Always get interrupted. And until the next time, I'll see you on Monday. Can't believe got a whole weekend off. Oh my God. And hopefully, fingers crossed, fingers crossed, I'll think of some more things to amuse you with over the weekend. What else have we got to? Oh yes, I've got to say, look after yourselves, look after each other, and don't forget, this is what the pig says.
That's all, folks.